Hi. Today, I'm going to take a look at this Phrozen Sonic Mini and see what's going on with that one. Hey everybody, Don here. How's it going? I hope everything's going good on your side, because today is not my day. You know, I had my Canon EOS 600 set up, connected, OBS Studio running, everything good, showing that the microphone was working. Microphone is on. Here it is. As you can see, it's working. But I do not know why. Yeah, let me just say, half an hour of video. You can remember back in the 1920s, 1930s, 1940s, when everybody was sitting for an open air or in some kind of a cinema, big screen. There's a black and white running on that, and somebody on the side is playing a piano. Well, if I had a piano, that would have been good, because I could have started playing the piano for that one. Complete unboxing, setting it up, starting the print, filmed with a camera, mic is recording, I see the LEDs moving on the mixer, I see the LEDs moving in OBS, but I have no idea where the sound is. Have to take a look and see if I can find it. Maybe it's saved it as an extra file or something like that. I don't know. But anyway, just to make sure, I'm making this one. Print's been running since 10:20. Since about 40 minutes. It's already at 21%. This is the Phrozen Sonic Mini. Mini. Oh, so small. This isn't. It's not even that small, you know. But just to give you a little bit of inside information here, that has a 2.8-inch touchscreen. Everything's there. Really easy to navigate through. Uses normal resin 405. The XY resolution on this, that's where it's interesting. It's a 0.0625 XY resolution, which means it can print something a little bit faster. Also, it has a monochrome screen on it, which also helps for the print speed. Not sure how that all really works out. That's something I'm going to have to learn, but yeah, this is the first resin printer for me, so you know, I got a lot to learn. But the build volume on this one is 120 millimeters by 68 millimeters and 130 millimeters print height. So 12 centimeters, 6.8 centimeters, and 13 centimeters. The print weighs 4.5 kilos. That's around about 11, 12 pounds, something like that. And it uses CheetoBox. I already have a CheetoBox installed, and I was looking at that a couple of days ago. There's also a YouTuber. It's the Cheetahbox team, where there's a lot of good videos in there where you can learn how to use Cheetahbox to the best way. There's some videos I'm going to have to watch. Right now that's a test print that is running that was on the SD card. Some kind of rings. We'll see. Take a look and see what kind of quality comes out. I already have my pickle jar here. This is a smaller one. Found a bigger one in Amazon. I put that on my wish list. So end of the month, if I have a little bit of money extra, I'll get a bigger one just to make sure. And anyway, got everything running. As you can see, I'm not using the mask, and I can't smell anything. But you know how that is when you smoke. Your nose is not as sensitive to certain smells, you know? But anyway, even if I turn the mic up a little bit, okay, let me turn the mic back down. I'm not sure if you were able to hear that, but that thing is really quiet. I mean, I have it on my desk right here. There's a TV in the background. If I turn the TV on, I want to listen to the news or whatever, I wouldn't have any problem at all listening to the news, because that thing is quiet, and I like that. The only thing that you really hear is the Z motor when it's moving up and down. That's the only thing that you really hear. I don't hear the fans at all. I hope it has a fan in it that's running. But yeah, I mean, it's really cool. And I'll also put a link down in the description for the FEP shop, where you can check it out. This printer is at 319 euros. Interesting for Europe. And can I say, is it worth buying this printer? Not yet. But this printer was sent to me to test out and review. I will be testing this out. An official review, well, let's say in a week or so. However, I will be making some videos one after another showing you what's coming out from there. I do have a lot of models already set up. All I have to do is just slice them and print them and then check it out and see how they come out. But anyway, if you want to take a look at that video, I'll add it on to the end here, where you can see where I was unboxing it and getting it set up. But until the next time, y'all take care. Have a nice day. Until the next video. Bye.